We're going to have the third tour of the Design Academy right now. It's the third and the last. So hoping if you want to have a chance to have a look inside. We're going to start with this floor, which is the sixth floor. It's the top of the building. It's the Z-Bar, and the Z-Bar is the restaurant of the school. It is a place where normally we can gather during the breaks, lunch and dinner. Now, because of the circumstances and the epidemic, we organized it a little bit differently because we cannot gather anymore. But normally you need to imagine that there is like a lot of chairs and tables and you can eat together. We're gonna have a little look at what is served here. Oh, this is the alarm that goes off. Wait, let's see. Yeah, it's okay. They are doing some reparation on the roof, so maybe it's gonna be solved. Let's have a look at the food in the meantime. They're always serving sandwiches and salads that are freshly made every day. You have a range of drinks. A range of snacks, and they also made homemade pastries every day, like this sticky caramel bar. And coffee. Coffee is the fuel, of course. It's really important to have it. We're gonna have a little look at behind the scene, just for you. Here is the inside of the kitchen. We have up to 4 people working here and preparing food for us every day. Now it's a bit the end of the day, so the rush is past, but normally you have a sandwich station and a salad station, and then cold preparation and the oven. They prepare every day croissant and pain au chocolat, and they are kind of a hit. Everybody loves them, of course. This is Terence. There is Marinka over there, and there is Mika at the phone. Mika is the manager of the Z-Bar. She's a kind of an important person in the school. She's doing a really great job with us and with the Z-Bar. So she doesn't want to be on camera, but we just like say hi, Mika. Hi, Mika. All right, let's continue. Maybe we can go through here. Okay, let's go. Let's go out. We now gonna get down to the fourth floor. We have to wait a second. Mika installed this device that helps us to circulate a little bit better in the Z-Bar because for Corona we are trying to avoid crossing each other, and we have to wait for the green light. Let's go. This is the fifth floor. The fifth floor is the master space. So we're not going to visit it today, but if you ever come here, you will have a look at it. Oh. Hello. Hello, girls.
Ça va?
Yes, we are recording the live tour of the school. Nice. You can say hello, it's live on YouTube. Fourth floor. The fourth floor is for the bachelor, second, third, and fourth year. The first year have their own floor that we're gonna have a look at later. But for now, we have the identity department. Every department have their own space with their own storage and their own classrooms. This is one, and we can have a look at the main room over there. here we have a class that is going on in the moonshot department, so we're not gonna bother them too much, but let's have a look anyway. Here is the living matter department. So as you can see right now, it's a bit empty, it's a calm, because we, students graduated last week and the week before for the masters. Normally it's way more busy. You have to imagine that there is classes going on in both sides, and you know there's no walls, so you have to kind of work with the crowd. It's an open space. And here we have another department, the invisible studio on the left. So here we have some remains of projects. This was electricity makers that you had to build in second year. Here we have some examples of the chair assignment. The chair assignment is an assignment in second year. It's an assignment that introduce the students to wood and plastic techniques, working together. This is the end of this floor, and now we can have a look at a little room over there. The glass room, it's called. So right now there's a meeting happening. But it's normally a room where reunions is happening, sometimes end terms, presentations, exhibitions. We try to keep it clean for this reason. And we're gonna go one floor down to the third floor, which is the floor dedicated to the first year bachelor. Alright, so this space, it's divided in three spaces, let's say. We have three semesters in the first year, and every semester has its own room, so we can have a look. Here we're gonna have a look at the mask assignment here on this wall. So as you can see, every student has to choose an animal and make three masks, one in paper, one in cardboard, and one in textile. And next week is the presentation of these masks, so everybody is kind of wrapping it up and trying to be ready for presentation. here on your right, you have two different little rooms. One is for the elevator radio, which is a radio that has been set up this year by a group of students, and that is going to be broadcasting every Thursday from now on. There is next to it the student council room. The student council is a group of students working together to be in contact with the board and administration, and they are trying to kind of communicate with them and also just work together to you know, improve the student life. We're gonna get through this space. Here you have on the right the shelves. Every student has their own shelf, and this is where you can store your ongoing projects. Here you have an example of an assignment on cardboard and ceramic, where you have to do a lot of iterations every week, bring new shapes and new experiments. And this is the fourth phase. In this space, they installed some machines to work on the metal assignments. In first year, you also have an assignment dedicated to folded aluminium. And they installed the kind of basic elements that you need to work with. And in the end of the room, you have another working space for the drawing and the painting assignments. At the end of the semester, you have to paint a 2x3 drawing, and we can have a little look at what's been produced. So as you can see, everybody is going a little bit wild with this assignment, which is really nice. We love it. So that's about it for the first year floor. We're going to go on with the textile workshop. So this is a textile workshop. There's a lot of people working already, so we're not going to interrupt too much, but I just wanted to show you the different types of machines. At the very end of the room, you have the tufting station. Here are some sewing machines. On the right side, we have weaving and knitting. Here on this wall, you have a bit of an overview of the material that you can purchase in the workshop. You also have some board of example of what can be done, for example here with a mini stuffed and a needle punch. This is all the manual weaving machines. The looms, they are called. Here is also another example of a series of examples of what you can do in the workshop. The instructors are always trying to guide us through the process and to teach us if we need to know how to use tools and machines. that's about it for the textile. Thank you for having us. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, now we're gonna go half a floor up on the 3D lab. We take the stairs. Here is the 3D lab. It's a space where you can use 3D printers with different types of materials. Now the structure is a bit busy, so we're going to have a little look around and maybe later we can have a little talk with them. Those are the 3D printers. We have other three here, and a bigger one here. Like in the other workshops, there's always samples of the way we can work with material. So it's nice to experiment in this workshop. We have a little. We already had a little look at the machine, but we wanted to know for the last third time if you could say just a few words about how do you work here and what can we make here if we're studying here.
Yeah. Well, in the future, your teachers will give you some practice and some things to work on. And one of the things you're about to learn is to work with 3D program to make a few tasks. Those tasks are translated into products that are to be printed. Those prints can be diverse. Most of them are made from filament. It's a plastic kind. PLA in this case is partly recycled. And you can make like solid parts. So this started off, as you can see on screen, like a 3D drawing, and while it's being printed, it's ending as an actual part. What we try to do is to encourage you to work also with other materials, to see what you can do. Like in fashion, you have non-hard materials, more flexible materials. So that could be more resembling this kind of material. And in such way, we try to push you a bit into new frontier. These are some things students are working on now. This is quite fresh. The student gave me this after he made his final ones. And this is all flexible and you can work on it. So this is like his product. And that's the nice thing, that it starts off as a 3D drawing. It needs some material and it becomes all of a sudden something you could use for a certain purpose. Besides the filament, we also can work like in really smooth products. So this is made with resin. You hardly see the making of it. It's like a product you could buy in the shop. Super smooth, fairly strong, and that's done with the printers we have. So it's starting off as prototypes and possibly ending in almost real life products. Besides that, we have a laser cutter doing sort of like wood, plastic, those kinds. This is an example of something to trigger students that not everything you're laser cutting should be flat. This is started off as a 3D model. It's unfolded and then you were able to make this like sewing together so it forms a helmet.
Nice, beautiful.
So I hope this workshop gives people the chance to experiment a bit more. That's why it's called 3D Lab.
Yeah. Nice. Thank you very much. Super good. Thank you for presenting it.
Perfect.
And yeah, we see you around.
Okay. Have a good trip.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right. There we go. Now we're going to go to the second floor. Yes. Here we have the library. The library is a mix of a collection of books and some magazines. We can have a little look. So Ivy is the librarian. She's working here. Now she has afternoon off, but she's the one in charge of the library. The library is a collection of books related to design, but also related to any other subjects in which you can research. It can go from science to philosophy. Ivy is always ready to include new books if you have suggestions for her. She's always happy to do that. And on the other side, there is the magazine section. The magazines are also most of them related to design, architecture, fashion. We're gonna have a look. So, yeah, you can see for every edition you have the other numbers next to it. It works like a normal library. And yeah. Ivy is always putting the new incoming editions here. And that's about it. We're gonna close behind us because it's closed today, so we don't want to leave it open. Oh, and we're gonna have a look at the digital workshop now. The digital workshop. I'm checking if the instructors are available to talk to us, but maybe not now. We're gonna have a little look anyway. Here it's the computer room that you can access with your identifiers. We have, for example, on this table a range of all the binding that you can do in this workshop. Basically, in here you have the opportunity to work on the computers, print with the printers here. You have different type of quality, different type of paper. And here you have the plotters. Plotters are machines that help you printing in bigger size. Those machines are quite complex, so for this kind of task, the instructors are here to help us. On the other side here, we have working stations. We can have a little look. We have different things that can be done. There is a heat press, if you want to flock some t-shirts like they are doing right now. Some cutting mats, cutting devices. And also some white box to take pictures of your project with a nice lighting. Yeah. the digital workshop, and we wanted to know if you could talk to us a little bit about what can be borrowed with you.
What can be borrowed? All types of equipment, microphones, cameras, card readers, that type of stuff. Anything you would need.
The GoPros?
GoPros, cameras, yeah. So anything that you would need to basically produce a multimedia
nice,
project.
Super nice. And so you have to book them through a website, the website of the school?
On the internet, you can book them, and of course there's a maximum to the amount of stuff you can book.
Fair enough.
If you come here, we can make exceptions sometimes.
Nice, nice. Yeah. And we also were wondering if the photo studios were was busy right now, if we could have a little look. Do you know?
It's busy right now.
Okay, okay. Yeah, so the photo studios is also a space where that we can use.
It's just basically just a large space with white walls.
Yeah.
And we have a white background, a black background, and a green background.
Some lighting.
For various purposes. Yeah, lighting, and a camera in there.
Mm-mm. And the last thing is also the UV printer, right?
Yeah.
The little room here where you can print on many more materials.
Yeah, for example, you can print on wood with this.
Mm-mm.
Or metal or whatever.
Nice. Good.
And then, basically, and it can also print white. Exactly.
Yeah.
So
that's the kind of extra added value to the UV printer. Nice. Okay. Super cool.
And then, of course, we have the computers and the printers and all that stuff.
Yeah, and we already showed a little bit.
Yeah.
But thank you very much.
All right. You're welcome. Cheers.
Bye-bye. All right. We are done with the digital. Let's have a look at what's left. All right. Here is the first floor. The first floor is divided in two spaces. Here is the ceramic workshop, and here the wood, metal, plastic, and silkscreen workshop. We're gonna have a look first at ceramic. The ceramic workshop is also a plaster workshop, actually. Here you have the plaster station, some tools, the water, the sink. Here, some working station that you can just sit at and work on your project. On the other side, we have the glazing station with a range of different glazing. You can really experiment with this. The instructors are always ready to help and to make it happen. On this side we have the molds. Some molds are already pre-done if you want to experiment with them. You can also make your own. And here you can have a look at some experiments, some projects and some glazing tests. This is personally the workshop in which I'm more comfortable, so I can talk to you for ages about it, but we have to keep it a bit short. One last thing, the kiln room. Here is the place where we bake the ceramics. There is three types of kilns, and this is handled most of the time by the instructors because it's kind of a Tetris to put in everything, it's really dealt with a lot of care, so we trust it. And that's it for the ceramic. Let's have a look at the other workshop. All right. I see André, the metal instructor, Hi, André. Okay, let's go in, let's go in.
Second round?
Third.
Third round, okay.
Hi, André. André is the metal instructor.
Hello, welcome to the workshop.
I wanted to know if you could show us a little bit the metal space.
Let's do that.
Yeah?
Okay.
Nice.
Yeah. Come. This is the metal workshop. Here we've got the blacksmith corner. We have here for soldering and that kind of stuff, spot welding. Of course, here the materials, different stocks here, so the loads of different materials. Those are the solid rods and bars. In this stock over here, we have different kinds and different thicknesses of sheet metals. And over there we have the tubes and the sections.
Nice, with so the cutting machine.
Those are more or less the materials that we have on stock. Yeah? And to do something with that, we got loads of machines, like press drills, bandsaw, punches, sheet cutters, all kinds of things you need to
Can I ask you,
grass, yeah.
André, what is your favorite machine?
My favorite machine is my lathe over there.
I knew,
yeah.
Okay, let's
they call it a lathe. When I say that nobody knows what it is, and when I say turning machine, they walk to this one.
This one?
This one, yeah. This is definitely my favorite. It makes everything which is circular, so now I'm busy with making these.
Nice, beautiful.
You can switch it on. And then you got away everything that you don't need. You see?
Nice. Huh? Wear some glasses.
Yeah, glasses. Okay. I like that.
Nice, beautiful.
And then continue. Yeah.
All right.
So we got two of them, one for us and one for the students.
Yeah.
And
all right.
Here we have our work benches. Oh, sorry. For all the handwork. Here we have a pantograph. It's a copying machine. The Tico is now copying a little mold that he 3D printed. The tester will follow that that template. And then you can cut it out into a piece of brass.
Wow, impressive.
This is also a mill. And with this one you can switch it on. And then cut away materials. So here you can cut away everything that you don't need. Just like sculpturing, but then in metal.
Wow.
Yeah, let's see. Got some contact. Yes. There we go. A little bit of oil. Sounds nice. Speed it up a bit. Here we have the welding corner.
Should we enter?
Yeah, enter. So here we have a MIG welder. We have MIG and TIG welders, different kinds of welding for different purposes.
Nice.
Yeah.
Super nice.
Good,
this is
vacuum
it.
Vacuum installation.
Yeah.
And here we have the grinding corner. So the grinding, we usually did it everywhere in the workshop, but it's bad for your health. So now we made this little corner for the dirty jobs.
With a air suction.
If you can't weld, you find yourself here in the loser corner, grinding off all the welds that didn't work out.
I've been there. All right. Thank you very much. Okay, we're gonna have a look at the wood. Thank you, André. This was the last tour. Now you are free.
Now I'm free to go.
Bye-bye. Okay. Now we have the wood workshop here. I think I can have a little tour with you. Those are the working stations. So what happens is that when you come in, you have to take a belt, and inside the belt you have a different type of tools.
You got that on camera, didn't you?
Here we have some sanding machines, the wood that you can buy for your project. This is a table saw. It's kind of an impressive machine, but it's actually really useful. You can work with big pieces of wood. Plastic workshop, we can have a little look. Just follow me. Here it is, the plastic workshop. Here is the space dedicated to all the range of plastic that you can work with. So it can go from mold making to just sculpting. You have some sanding machines. You also have a saw that is dedicated to PU plastic only, which is this kind of foam. You have a suction system over there to kind of avoid inhalating the fumes. And you also have on the other side, it is closed today, but I'm gonna mention it. There is the silkscreen workshop, where you can create your own silkscreen frame and print on different type of material. On this side, this other side, you have a CNC milling machine. You work from a computer file, and then they are going to sculpt into different types of material with the CNC, with the drill that goes in. So you can have a look. And here, on the side, you have some examples of what can be done with this machine. So this is an example of an assignment that you have in first year, the chocolate assignment, where you learn how to design your own chocolate, and then you make molds for them. You go to a chocolate maker in Belgium, and then you pour your own chocolate. This is a like A to Z project, which includes the CNC milling. This is it for the workshop. We're gonna have a look at the last room here. All right. This is also a classroom. It is a bit calm now because people did graduate already, but it's always nice to have a look. You have different projects going on. that's about it. It's a bit the same space then for the first year, where you have an open space to work, have class, and just be there from 8 to 21, 21:30 during the week. And yeah, we're going to continue with the last part and get out of the building with the entrance door. Right, then we're gonna go down. This was the last floor, let's say. Follow me because I want to show you a last little thing. They're not there, but I want to show you the conciergerie. This is where the concierges are working. There are like four people. And hey, Mike. Four people working here, and they are helping us often for different kind of stuff. They know how to open all the doors. They have a lot of equipment. It's always good to know where to knock out. Now that's the conciergerie. And this is it, we can get out.
Yes. Hey. Did you manage to make Ursula? Hi.
And this is it. This was the end of the last tour. You're gonna have a look at the entrance. This is where we come in and go out every morning and evening. This is also where we park our bikes. Yeah, this was it for today. I hope you enjoyed. I hope we didn't forget anything. If you have any questions, of course, you can always ask on the YouTube channel. And yeah, I hope I will see you next year. Have a good evening. Bye-bye.